We run a program for the entire month of October where we bring in schools all over the island, usually primary schools. They apply to come into the FRC, and we are instructing them on the culture of the country as it relates to dance, music, the history of St. Lucia, various cultural icons, their contribution to the country's economy, basically, and the country's upliftment culturally. And it is something that we want to promote, we want to continue as an FRC. As I said again, it's not purely the eating, the drinking, the fun, but it's also the aspect of the education. We have some sponsors on board. We had this morning sponsors like this, the Bank of St. Lucia and the National Community Foundation that has been providing assistance in that regard. And we have a number of specialists like Jason Butler-Joseph. This morning he'll be here doing dance and music. And there'll also be people like Gary Booth, who does art. Then there's also people like Booth Samuel, who does education in terms of the history and culture of St. Lucia. And many others, people like June Frederick, who does masquerade. That's an area that some of our students are not aware of. And this is an area that Mrs. June Frederick is quite versed in. So basically, we are out here ensuring that our cultural education continues and our people, especially our children, appreciate what our folks, you know, what St. Lucia is all about. What is to be a St. Lucian? What is to be Creole? What's the Creoleness about us? And why are we involved in this aspect of our lives?
Many might ask, why would the NCF support a program like this? A program which has to do with culture and heritage. Because most persons know the NCF for its scholarship program and its health, assistance program. But part of the NCF's mandate is to also contribute and promote how it can community development and civic affairs. And we see this type of program as falling right into the type of program that we should support. After all, Mr. Lee has explained to you, the FRC is an educational institution. Okay, it's a place where they store a lot of information and knowledge about what happens in St. Lucia, not just, as he says, the past, but what continues to happen. So they're continuously researching and recording. And we think that's a very important venture, something that needs to happen. As he said, if you do not know your past, then you certainly don't know where you're going.
Bank of St. Lucia has been supporting the FRC for many, many years. Particularly with this education program that is ongoing, we really applaud the efforts of FRC. I know that sometimes it can be very difficult to coordinate these type of activities when you have to deal with schools, ministry, teachers, and coming, you know, actually getting people here. Bank of St. Lucia has always supported youth development. This is the crux of what we do for our corporate social responsibility. And youth development, we support initiatives that come in various forms. So you'll hear us supporting sports, you'll hear us supporting other educational activities. So education and culture are the two areas that we also support for youth development. So we're very pleased to be here this morning.